to my channel. My name is Vinay, and in today's video, I need to share with you things you should know before moving to study abroad. I know I make a video which explains the reason why you need to go to study abroad. So if you happen to watch that video, make sure you link on the description box because I have explained all the reasons why you need to study away from your home country. But also, I decided to make this video so that when you make a decision, you are in a right place. Things you should know before moving from your country to study abroad. So make sure you join Vinay TV by subscribing, and if you like my video, make sure you comment down, like the video, and share with some friends who are really like about the things I do on my channel. Please subscribe. Things that you're supposed to know is have enough money before leave your country. So if you are planning to go to study abroad in anyhow, maybe under scholarship or without a scholarship, make sure you know you have enough money for you to go to study abroad. If you just go there, you're expecting that after arriving you will find a part-time job, so you don't need to go with enough money, or you're expecting life is gonna be easy, or you are expecting your scholarship is gonna be on time, as you guys, you plan things gonna go different way. So before for you going abroad, make sure you have enough money. It's really hard for the first year, and sometimes there's a lot you have to do. There's a medical checkup, there's a lot you're supposed to do, and a lot of things where you're supposed to buy, and all of this is depending with your pocket money, whether you're in a scholarship or you are not in a scholarship. So before leave your country, make sure you have extra money rather than just coming abroad without having enough money. I saw many freshmen struggling, and some of them been give up, some of them been decided to go back home because they don't have enough money. And the thing that you're supposed to be careful is if you go abroad without having tuition fee, because I saw most people, they're expecting after arriving, that's why they want to pay tuition fee, or after arriving is the same whereby their parents will pay, or after some times. But your tuition fee is the one determining your visa in abroad. Most countries that want to provide for you visa if you haven't made all payments, because when you're gonna leave your country, they are just give you short-term visa, maybe 1 month or 2 months only. Then other visas is gonna provide by your school after make all the payments. So make sure you have enough money. If it's your tuition fee, your pocket money, or necessary thing, first year is very necessary for you to have enough money once coming to study abroad. Another thing you're supposed to know is be mentally and emotionally ready. So you have to prepare yourself and know that you are going to a country where it's a foreign land and people are different. There's no friends, there's no mom, there's no sister, there's no neighbors which you used to stay with. So you're going in a place, you're going to find different people. You are just you, know that you're gonna be alone. So you're supposed to prepare your mind and emotionally ready. Don't expect people are gonna be so kind to you, or people are gonna stay with you all the time, people are gonna be with you all the time until you get used to it. No, life won't go like that. So you're supposed to be mentally and emotionally ready that in a foreign land, everyone is busy with his or her own study and other matters, so people won't be there for you. So get prepared that you're gonna face a lot of challenges. Life is going to be easy, because most people have been like, if I go abroad, my life it will be easy. If I go abroad, I'll make a lot of money. If I go abroad, I'll be like somebody. We have this assumption, which I can say is negative assumption. At the end, life gonna be different, and most people, they just end up drop out from school, and some of them, they just end up like going out, like drop out from school and they're going back at home. So you're supposed to be mentally and emotionally ready. Just know like things won't be the way you planned. Things, it's gonna take time to go smooth, and sometimes even you might stay abroad for 1 year or even 2 years, but you didn't see the direction way where you would actually settle. So be prepared that things won't be the same as you think. It might be very bad, and it must be good. So be mentally and emotionally ready. Another thing you're supposed to know is the loneliness and underestimation is really high in abroad, because you can see you are coming from different country and in a community whereby there's more than 30,000 students. Everyone came from different background, and you might find there the seniors who already have more and more connection, they know how to make money, they have part-time job. So there's a lot. So there's the underestimation, which is little high. You're supposed to know which kind of family you came from so that you could just know this is just a way, it's just a beginning, and that is why you are starting to grow. So loneliness is just there, and some of them, once you are just a newcomer, people are gonna expect you came with a lot of money, so people are gonna need to know which family you came from if you have money, so that they can be friend with you. But if you won't show that you have money, or if you are poor just like us, then you won't have those friends. You won't have those friends because people, they are there to get something. People, they are there, they expect, like, okay, you're gonna provide something for them, and you want to do that. So you're gonna be lonely because maybe of how you dress. Not that, because of how you dress, because you are just like a back person like that. So people, they won't stick on you. So just know there's more loneliness once alive in abroad, because people, you just found like it's a different way, everyone is different style, everyone is different fashion. It's crazy. You have been in a country whereby all of you have the same culture, practice, you have the same thing, and you guys, you used to stay together. But you are going in a place whereby you might find people from different countries, let's say 40 countries in a one place. So be careful. And just know, loneliness is always there, and you might get more people who will underestimate you, and some of them, maybe they won't do that, but that is obvious in abroad. The thing you're supposed to know is, it will be hard to connect you with your friend and family on time, and sometimes your friend back home, they might think you feel proud because you went abroad. You might lose many friends when you go abroad. This is obvious like that. And some of them, like, nowadays you change because you and abroad, but actually life is not like that. Maybe sometimes life is too difficult, even you can't be in touch with them. Sometimes you pass in greater problem, but back home your friends, they won't even understand that. And the most major thing is time difference, because maybe you have 6 hours difference or 12 hours difference. People, they won't understand that. The only thing is they just put this negative thought toward you. So be ready to lose friends back home, be ready to get this negative push. Even though you didn't change, you are the same person, people, they will say you really changed because you went abroad. These things are like that. So be ready for that. And sometimes people, they might see like you don't respect them, but the truth is that is how life is in abroad. And once you just go abroad, this is how our friends just change perception, because you used to stay with them, so now you just departure each other, so that like you just went abroad and you started to forget me, which is not true. The thing you're supposed to know about study abroad is failure, give up, fake friends, no motivation. This is obvious there in abroad. Most you get a fake friend, and sometimes maybe you want to do well on your subject, you end up failing in some subject. No one is there to encourage you sometimes, and most people, they just end up to underestimate you because you fail in a certain subject. So you might end up have this depression about your studies, and sometimes you might say like, I think I don't fit in this course, I have to change this course, and you might get negative advice from people. So you're supposed to be very careful. That is how life in abroad is. And sometimes maybe when you are back home, you was getting more backup from your sisters, brothers, even your friends, they are motivated you. But in abroad, there's no motivation, because everyone is struggling to be the best version of his or himself. Or sometimes everyone struggling to be the best than you. So there's no motivation at all, and just people, there's not anyone who will actually feel the way you feel. So be prepared for no motivation, and then you'll get more fake friends, more and more fake friends, people by their talk back of you. So that is how life in abroad is. So be prepared mentally and emotionally about this. Another thing you're supposed to be careful about is that abroad is sending GST to your family is gonna be more and more and more expensive. Once you go abroad from your country, when you need to start in another country, people expecting that maybe if you go to China, things are cheap and obviously you're gonna send goods back home, GST, something like that. But sending goods from China, let's say, to back in your home country can be very, very, very expensive. So you won't expect it to send, maybe if you are young brother's birthday, maybe it's your friend's birthday, you want to send a gift, it will be extremely, extremely very expensive, and you are in a tight budget, so you won't expect it to do much for your family, you won't expect to do much for your brothers or even for your friends. But back home, they do expect you to do something. They won't understand the real cost of how much it costs there. So that is how life is. So your expectation can be different with the reality in abroad, and you don't expect it, because once people they need to study, let's say China, they're like, okay, China is cheap, when I go to China I'll be sending you good phones, something like that. But once you arrive in China, things change, everything change. So your expectation about a certain country is going to be very, 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 very different. Another thing you're supposed to be careful is, this goes mostly for boys, and I saw it, you won't get enough support from home. And especially if the family will know that you are under scholarship, let's say your scholarship cover tuition fee, cover accommodation. So family only give you money for eating, let's say. So you won't get that enough support from home, and especially maybe you are in blood, but you are not under scholarship. As long as you're a boy, back home, our family can force you to find a part-time job. Not that not all countries allow us to work. Like in China, it's illegal to work. You are not allowed. But you won't get that much support from home. And sometimes I might tell you, you have to do something for yourself. So be careful about this, and don't be discouraged. Like my family don't provide for me support as it was before. And most of students get depression. Most of people go into depression about this. And especially when you're abroad, your family can tell that we have problems, so this month we want to send you money. They don't understand exactly how life in abroad is expensive. They don't understand how life in abroad, there's not anyone to support you. If you don't have money, you want it. It's not like back home. They won't understand about that. So you might end up have no support back in your country, back in your home. Maybe your family can give you little money, not like enough money for you to survive in abroad. And mostly goes to boys. They're just like, you grow up, you went abroad, do something, find a part-time job, something like that. So things just happen like that. So be prepared once you need to go to study abroad. Another thing you're supposed to be careful is time management and the financial lady. When I say time management, it's because you might have many assignments, and you have many things you have to do, and you have activities. There's a lot you have to participate in, any school activities that happen, and you have your own things. Let's say you conduct a small business, you have to do, and maybe you have this perception, when I go abroad, I will travel in many countries. So you saw many people, maybe on YouTube, you saw people that travel, people that go in this country, people that go in this country, and you think maybe when you're in your blood, you travel like them. Things won't work like that. And these people, they have plan back, they know everything, and they have more experience, they know what they're doing. So don't go and jump and start to travel. You can find a cheaper way to travel from one way to another. You can use bus, you can use train, which is more and more cheaper. And yes, there's a lot which actually you can use to travel cheaper, but don't expect life it's gonna be easy like that. And sometimes people that just end up have this luxury life, and they forgot to do homework, which end up to drop out from school. Be careful with your time, be careful with your time. And I saw this, most people try to keep to connect with their friend, talk with them through phones every night. They just end up drained to class. So this it might end up you to drop out from school. Just know what brought you to school. Just know I have to do this. So make it priority. What brought you to a certain country, make sure you do it before making your other things. Those are things you're supposed to be careful once you're planning to study abroad. I didn't sugarcoat anything at here. I just need you to be mentally and emotionally ready. If I will sugarcoat, you won't actually understand. Yes, I made a video which explained the reason why you need to study abroad, and make sure you link on the description box. So I hope this tips will make you to be more aware about abroad, and when you make a decision to study abroad, it will be wise and good decision according to you. But also, study abroad is good experience because it's like a grow up process. It's the one you discover yourself and you grow, and you won't have somebody like your family always with you. So it's just like that. So I hope this tip is gonna help you. Please don't afraid to come abroad because of what I mentioned here. It's just normal. That is how life is. If you're new to my YouTube channel, consider subscribing, share my video please. For anyone who like it to know more about video, make sure subscribe and like this video.